Have you ever asked, would I be good at flipping houses? Is that something I could learn and do with success? Am I cut out for it? Well, the good news is anyone can learn how, but I believe there are 7 signs that you'd pick it up quickly and you'd be really good at it. So on today's video, find out if you have what it takes to flip houses. Coming up. Hi, it's Jerry Norton, and one of the things that I've learned is that everyone progresses at different levels. When it comes to flipping houses, some people seem to naturally pick it up really quickly, and others seem to struggle to get going. Some people get deals right out of the gate, and some take a while to get their first deal, and many quit early before ever getting their first deal. Now, before we dive into this video, I want you to know it doesn't matter how you start, it matters how you finish. Don't compare yourself to others. Compare yourself to yourself. As long as you keep learning and keep moving forward, it will come and you'll see success. That was certainly the case with Scotty Free from Alabama. Scotty was a crane operator and desperately wanted to get out of that chair and live life on his own terms. He came to my Elite Mentoring Program, and when he first started, he was so scared to talk to people, but he wasn't afraid to try. He kept working at it and applying my 6-figure profit system, and he learned. It took some work and some patience, but he recently did his first deal and made over $18,000. Now, I can't tell you how excited he was and how proud I am of him. Right now, he's working on several more deals and it's starting to click for him. So anyone can learn how to successfully flip houses, but there are 7 signs that you would pick it up quickly and be really good at it. If you possess these 6 things, then you'd be crazy not to flip houses. If you don't have them, then the good news is you can work to develop these qualities. Let's cover them now, but first, if we've never met, I'm Jerry Norton, and this channel is dedicated to helping you make more money right now in real estate, not later in 10 or 20 years, or even 3 to 5 years, but right now so that you can achieve true financial freedom and live your dream life. Consider subscribing to my channel, click the bell icon to get notified when new videos are released. The first sign is being able to say, I don't know. Willing to admit that you don't know automatically puts you in a growth mindset. It allows you to be open for feedback. You become quick to adapt and learn new skills about your market and strategies and methods to improve your business because you recognize there is always something you can do better. It's okay that you don't have all the answers. In fact, you shouldn't have all the answers. One of my mentors taught me a valuable lesson. He said, "My goal is to be the dumbest person in the room." Now think about what that means. You want to surround yourself with people who know more than you and are smarter than you. A lot of people don't want to feel inferior, and they do everything in their power to appear to be the smartest and have all the answers. Now if this doesn't come natural to you, don't think that in business or as a company owner, you have to know everything and have all of the answers. As you grow your team, bring on people that are better at specific things than you are. If you have a team of, let's say, 5 people who each do their role better than you can do their role, then collectively, you'll have a killer team and a killer business. Okay, sign number 2 that you'd be good at flipping houses is that you learn by doing. The people I've seen pick up flipping the fastest, learn a concept, then do it. Learn a technique, then do it. Get an idea, then implement. They're constantly applying whatever new thing they learn. The opposite of this is what I call analysis paralysis. This is when you have to study it forever and you have to have everything perfect before you do anything. Remember, sloppy success is way faster than perfect success. When I lived in Argentina for 2 years, I learned Spanish fluently in about 4 months because I wasn't afraid to speak, even though I was making mistakes. People learn in a foreign language that hold back for fear of messing up take a long time to learn the language. If you have a type A personality or an engineer mind and you struggle with perfectionism, you're going to need to work on this. Learn to follow your gut. Practice taking imperfect action. Tell yourself doing it now at 80% is better than doing it later at 100%. The third sign that you'd be good at flipping houses is you realize many questions have no answers. There is no one size fits all. There isn't a perfect strategy or a technique that works every single time, all the time. Real estate is constantly changing. Technology is constantly changing. Everything is constantly changing. The one thing about this business that is constant, that doesn't change, is that people live in houses. That's it. Over the years in my training business, I've created hundreds of videos explaining step-by-step how to do something. I created advanced training programs and scripts and everything imaginable because so many people want an answer to every question. People who excel at flipping are good at researching what they need and are okay to move forward without having all the answers. Now, if you struggle with this, Tell yourself it's okay if I don't have all the answers. It doesn't mean it doesn't work. It means you have to find your own answers, and that's okay. The fourth sign that you'd be good at flipping houses is you can explain it to a kid. Keep it simple. I refer to this as keep it kindergarten. Don't overcomplicate it. If you can't explain it so that a kid could understand it, then you don't understand it yourself. Don't turn it into a 47-step process. For example, so many people get bogged down with estimating repairs. I did a video where I show how to estimate repairs on any house in 60 seconds using a simple algorithm that is easily explained and easily understood. If you struggle with overcomplicating things, focus on the big picture. Try and get out of the weeds. Learn the concepts and let the details work themselves out naturally, and keep it kindergarten. The fifth sign that you'd be good at flipping houses is you're able to visualize it. If you're wholesaling, you can see in your mind's eye finding a motivated seller, getting a contract, finding a cash buyer, and closing and making a profit. If you're fixing and flipping, you can see the process of taking an ugly house and transforming it into a beautiful house that you can sell for a profit. If you can't clearly see in your mind's eye, then you can't actualize it in reality. If you struggle with this, find out what gaps you're missing in your mind's eye and get a clear picture of how you move from a lead to a deal. Watch this video to get a clear understanding of how the business works, and then spend time visualizing yourself successfully doing deals, going to closings, and cashing big checks. The sixth sign that you'd be a good flipper is you're not afraid of rejection. This is a big one. I often tell new investors that they have to make 100 offers to get one deal in the beginning. That means 99 no's to get one yes. For a lot of people, they can't handle the rejection. It wears them down. They take it personally and they start to believe their doubts. I've seen it over and over. The most successful flippers just let it roll off of them like water on a duck. It doesn't faze them. They understand that for every no, they are that much closer to a yes. People tell me all the time, "You're crazy. Go play in traffic. Go pound sand. I'm so offended by your low offer." It just means they're not motivated right now. That's all. Who cares? Moving on, because there is a motivated seller out there right around the corner that is waiting for me to help them. If you struggle with rejection, practice this simple exercise. Every time you make an offer that is rejected, say the following: "Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now I am that much closer to a yes and a big fat check." This will help you keep a positive vibe and not let the rejection build into negativity. And the last sign that you'd be a good flipper is you are quick to outsource as many tasks as you can. You look for ways to automate as many of the processes as you can, and you find really good talent to delegate the processes to. You understand that this is the key to free yourself from the day-to-day grind. The good news is you don't need a big team to do this. You need a few key people and the right technology. That is why I recommend to flippers who are serious about making a six-figure and even seven-figure income flipping houses to get my Flipster deal management system. If you've never heard of Flipster, it's a cloud-based, all-inclusive house flipping deal management system. Not only does it organize, streamline, and automate all of the steps to flipping houses, but it actually finds and funds deals for you. It's really awesome, so whether you're looking to do your first deal or you're already doing deals every month, Flipster can take you to the next level. So if you're into flipping, you owe it to yourself to check it out. Just click the link in the description. So if you're not afraid to say, "I don't know," if you're able to learn by doing, if you realize that many questions don't have answers, if you're able to explain it to a kid and can visualize yourself being successful, and if you aren't afraid of rejection and you're quick to outsource, automate, and delegate, then you would make a great flipper. And if those things don't come naturally, you can develop those skills and traits with some practice, some work, and some effort. If you learned something on this video, show some love, hit that like button, and leave a comment. Share with me the one of those things that you're best at and the one thing that you need to work on the most. I'd love to hear from you. If you haven't yet, be sure to subscribe to my channel. I'm dedicated to helping you make more money and less time flipping houses so you can live your dream life. And remember, it's not about the money, it's about having the time and freedom to have, be, do, and give everything you want in life. That's what it's all about, and I'll see you on the next video.